kind of a grinding thing. You know, we're really just starting to get into that part of it. I think you've heard Kirk say several times that, you know, last week was more like spring ball. These guys are, I mean, I got to hand it to these guys. It's amazing. You know, they are practicing. They're going to school. They're taking exams. They're, you know, doing all this stuff that, you know, we never had to ask them to do before when I was here. And I really admire how they go about their business and how they work at it, because it is not easy, you know, being up at, you know, 6 a.m. to maybe make a lift. You're off to class after that, you're back in practice at 6:30 in the afternoon. Those are tough days. The NCAA had a little more respect for the job that these guys, you know, do, but unfortunately they look at things a lot different. These guys have done a great job, and we're just really getting into camp now. So everybody to this point's really been up and down. I expect it to be up and down almost for another week for sure, as we as we push through the last, you know, 3 or 4 installs in the offense.
Coming from CJ last year to what you have this year, how different do they compare or not compare to them?
Well, you know, I mean, I didn't coach. I never got the chance to actually coach CJ. And we recruited him. And then obviously I left and he came in. And my first day back, I ran into him in the building. He kind of gave me a, you know, hey, what's up, coach? You know, you I get here, you leave, you know, I'm leaving and you get here, you know, so, you know, what's going on? You know, CJ, you know, seemed to, you know, he came from a football family, and, you know, he knew what he's doing in football from the time he, you know, probably was, you know, 10 years old, so, but I never coached him. I can't compare him to, you know, any of these guys. He certainly can let his record speak for himself, that's for sure.